All right, you can see where the metal has been folded up. So this is the this side here is the bottom. This would be the bottom of it, and this here is going up on the frame. So the first thing I got to do, even to get this control arm off of this stock bracket, is to cut this metal that's been bent out of the way. See how cheesy this shit is, man. It's too bad, really. Yeah, just use the cutting wheel. Made an opening so I can get a socket or a wrench on that to separate the control arm from this lower control arm bracket. I think we can save that. In Hollis, Queens. Mom's cooking chicken and collard greens. Rice and stuffing macaroni and cheese. And Santa put gifts under Christmas trees. Decorate the house with lights at night. Snow's on the ground, snow white so bright. In the fireplace is the Yule log. Beneath the mistletoe as we drink eggnog. The rhymes that you hear are the rhymes of carols. Like each and every year we bust Christmas carols. Christmas carols. A lot of people have asked me how it looks under there on the frame. So there's the axle end where the lower control arm was disconnected by Mike. I want to pan over to my rock hard 4x4 belly armor. So this is a panel here that opens up and accesses the drain plug to change the oil. Unfortunately, this got pressed up really hard high. As it continues, it basically makes contact with the bottom of the motor. But I have another Rubicon Express piece of 3/16 armor underneath the oil pan. So I think we're fine. I got to disconnect all of this. This is always the problem. You can see I'm missing a bolt right here. These rock dome washers, I'll have to get a Dremel and Dremel all around this to get a socket in to get the nuts off. So if I can get this one piece off right here, drop the belly armor, maybe put it in a press, straighten it out, maybe even weld some channel in there to kind of strengthen it. Or worst case scenario, I'll have to buy a new piece. Just to look at the undercarriage here. The farm is no joke, and we hit the black trails that it has to offer pretty hard. I still think this was kind of a fluke, so I'm going to pan over to the inside of the frame, right up in here where the control arm was mounted. We're going to take a look at that. Okay, there you go. You can see the outline, and sad to say, clearly it just was not welded very good. You can see that it actually broke loose. You just didn't have good penetration on the metal. You can see precisely where it was, right in here. So I'm in the process of looking at a couple options. Synergy sells a set for $160. Barnes sells a set for $50. They're both 3/16. I was hoping to find some quarter inch stock. So I'm going to look at the pros and cons of that. Up here you can see all my, these are all the feeds to my rock lights up here behind this piece of insulation. So that's what we have. There's a good look how it just basically broke off nice and easy. No damage whatsoever into the frame. The frame is fine. It broke right at the edge of the weld all the way around.